Oh, this stable brings back many memories to me. Oh, in the summers, we used to sit in the east watching the stars go by. Then one winter, we came to this stable from far, far away. With its warm fire, its frosted up window, and snow settling at our feet. It was that winter that we saw a miracle happen. Still have the headpiece that I wore on that night. For what we're about to share with you, in fact, what they are about to share with you, is based on a true story that happened long, long ago. But some of the conversations are fictitious, and they've even added a few extra characters. So don't forget the he's behind you's and the obligatory booze. So sit back, relax, kick off your shoes. It's time for the Nativity Pantomime at Bevan View. Didn't happen like that at all. I was there. Gosh. Nothing like that at all. Don't believe a word of it.
You left your mic on.
Congrats on your engagement, Joseph. Under the thumb. Forever now, eh?
Nah, I'm not worried. I'm totally chill, mate. It's going to be a long engagement. I'm still a free man for a long time yet, buddy. Many more beer and curry nights still to come.
Nice costume, mate.
Costume? Can I just saddle up my tap, please, mate?
You certainly can, sir. There we go.
Busy night tonight.
Oh, is it? Lovely, that's all gone through for you, sir. Have a Merry Christmas.
Now it's nearly Christmas time, we bring to you our pantomime. Not in the land of fairy tale, but in the land of Israel.
No Cinders here, no Sisters spotty, no Aladdin, no Jack, no Giants grotty, but wise men three and shepherds a few, an ox, an ass, and a camel.
Poo. It starts with an angel telling Mary,
"Fear not, a bun is in your oven. But it's not from your man Joseph. Instead, it's from God in heaven."
Whoa, that was quick. I best marry Joseph before people start to talk. No one will believe this baby came from a stork.
I haven't gotten around to telling Joseph yet. I'll get a message to him later. I'm sure he'll be fine though. His baby will be perfect. There will be nobody greater.
I know. I'll give him a call now.
I wouldn't do that. No, not yet. No.
Joseph! I'm Preggers. I know we haven't... No. But hear me out. Don't be mad. It's okay. No, there isn't anyone else. You're my only love. This baby is from God on high. No. I'm not high. No, don't hang up. Joseph? Hello? Oh, golly. Gosh. Oh, my.
Didn't take the news well?
No. He wants a divorce on the sly.
Okay. Bye.
That night, whilst Joseph was sleeping, he was sleeping, do as you wish, an angel popped into his dream. It glowed bright white, like...
Mr. Whippy Ice Cream?
Ooh.
Fear not. Your lady is pregnant with God's holy son. I'm so sorry you missed out on all the sexy fun. You'll have plenty more kids down the line. This one, though, he'll turn water into wine.
Whoa, what a dream. It'll be a Nazareth scandal. Mary will be missing out the most, though, if you know what I mean. Everyone knows I have a size 12 sandal. The wedding is back on. The truth I now know. I'm glad Mary's faithful. I knew she'd never be a...
Ho! Ho, ho. You better watch up. You better not cry.
Oh, no, 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 no. Santa Claus is in the next panto show.
Bless. So Joseph met up with Mary.
Did you get that message from the, what's the word? The shiny guy?
Harry Hill?
No, the guy with wings.
Colonel Sanders! Ooh.
Not Kentucky Fried Chicken wings, Joseph. He's bright white.
The Michelin man?
No, you know. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head, and I feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead.
And through it all, she offers me protection.
No, not now.
That's the word I was thinking of. Angels. Did an angel visit you too?
Oh, yes. He came to me in a dream, then vanished, leaving behind his glass shoe.
Wrong panto.
Oh, just spicing it up. It was worth a go. Anyway, Mary, our son will be king of the earth.
I hope he isn't wearing a pointy crown when I finally give birth.
Ouch.
Joseph and Mary were so in love, they got married that very night. Joseph wore tails and Mary painted her nails and wore a wedding dress of white.
Oh, man. Do you, Mary, take Joseph to be your husband?
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. All I want for
a baby.
I do.
Okay. And do you, Joseph, take Mary as your wife?
I feel it in my fingers. I feel it in my toes. Christmas is all around me, and so the feeling grows. It's written in the wind, it's everywhere I go. So if you really love Christmas, come on and let it snow. You know I love Christmas, I always will. My mind's made up by the way that I feel.
There's no beginning, there'll be no end. 'Cause on Christmas, you can depend. You gave your presents to me, and I gave mine to you. I need Mary beside me in everything I do, I do, I do, oh, I do.
You could have just said I do. Such a diva.
But you... You may now kiss the bride.
Did you not hire a string quartet for this moment, Joseph?
The musicians cancelled last minute. They all had a bad case of tinselitis.
Don't worry, not a problem. I have got just the thing. Here we go. Ah. That'll. Oh no, that's not what we need. Hang on a moment. Try again. Yes, this will do. No, not that either. Let's have another go. Aha! No.
All right, Reverend Poppins, take your time.
No, bear with me. Just the thing. Aha! Yes. Hang on. What? No, not that. I can't wait for you. Bit inappropriate.
Good evening. You're listening to Ashdown Radio, and now a lovely piece for all the lovers out there. So sorry, I have to interrupt this soothing music for an emergency government message.
This is a government announcement. Caesar Augustus has issued a decree that an empire-wide census should be taken. As part of this census, everyone must travel to their hometowns to be registered. You must leave immediately. I repeat, you must return to your hometowns to be registered. Thank you.
Well, okay, before I head home myself, let's get back to the music. How
a young heart really feels. And you are from the family of David, my Joe.
Yes, Bethlehem, the city of David, is my hometown. Let's go.
Promised you wouldn't use childish sound effects like that. I'm a professional actor.
Oh, no, 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 my dear. You aren't in a fit state to be on the back of a donkey. That's no place for a lady in your condition.
So Mary and Joseph made their way to Bethlehem to find somewhere to stay. They travelled on the back of a donkey called Bill. Very handy for when going uphill. To help the donkey cope with the weight, we sang this song on their special date.
Little donkey, little donkey,
little donkey
on the dusty
little
road. Gotta keep on plodding onward with your precious load.
Certainly a load.
Been a long time, little donkey.
Certainly a long time.
No
waiting about it.
Winter's night.
Don't give up now.
Little donkey, Bethlehem's in sight. Ring out those bells tonight. Bethlehem, Bethlehem. Follow that star tonight. Bethlehem, Bethlehem. Little donkey.
Give me some of that.
Little donkey.
I was enjoying that.
They arrived in Bethlehem at the dead of night.
Ugh, with all that gas and air, I'm high as a kite.
I think that was the donkey farts, but it does the same kind of thing.
Hey, that wasn't me, if that's what you was wondering.
Now, we need to find somewhere to stay before the baby is here.
More like you can, so you can have a beer.
Oh, hey, I'm more of a wine man anyway.
Yeah, tell me about it. Just knock and see, to see if there's a spare room. I need to get this boy out my flipping womb.
Joseph knocked on a hotel door. And a man peered round it and said,
"Sorry, sir, there's no rooms here. That gentleman just took our last bed."
Mary was shocked.
Ugh.
What is there left to do?
But try behind door number two.
He knocked again on the inn next door. And a similar looking man peered round.
"Sorry, old chum. All our guests are sleeping. If you could keep down the sound..."
Joseph walked a little bit further. Mary squealing in pain.
This one better not be fully booked again.
"I'll leave you guys to it. So long, enjoy your birth."
"Hello?
Evening, traveller. Do you have a reservation?"
"Oh no, we've just arrived from the north of the nation."
"On vacation?"
"Oh no, just our census destination."
"Oh, I notice your pregnancy situation."
"Yes, we're looking for a room and, some hydration."
"We are in a spot of desperation."
"Okay, I have no room." "But I do have a kind reputation. So just for you, I give you the consolation."
Sorry, is this a good time for a spot of narration? Okay, let's move it on to the bit where you give birth to a king, born for our salvation.
As the innkeeper waved them in, Mary and Joseph followed him with no hesitation.
"So let me get this right. You came from the north of the nation, but with no reservation. As it's not a vacation, but instead it's a census destination. With a pregnancy situation, hands needing..."
hideration.
I see the desperation. With my kind reputation, I'll give you good consolation for the boy of our
salvation.
Oh, and
congratulations.
Okay. There are no more rooms anymore. The last one was taken.
Another go.
But
I can see your wife.
She's about to
blow.
So, can I interest you in a bed of
hay?
And I'll
charge you nothing
for your stay.
For goodness sake, I'm a serious actor.
Serious actor?
I am. I did a GCSE in drama, actually.
Don't let them know about the
amadroppings on the floor.
Nor about the
noisy animals
in the
room next door.
I'll take it!
That is great.
I hope it doesn't smell.
No worries, Mama.
The place is
full of
poo-pourri. If you need anything,
just yet.
Oh, she'll be doing plenty of yelling. Maybe pop some earplugs in, as these walls are looking pretty thin.
They settled on the stable floor where Mary began giving birth to a boy. She used a manger as a cot.
And they'll name him Roy.
No, we won't, you cow.
I'm an ox.
Jesus will be his name.
And they relaxed and sang this peaceful song together as Mary waited till her baby came.
Two, three.
Anyone order a nurse?
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
Pull yourself together.
Okay.
I'm pretty annoyed right now. Why do you have to get another narrator to do this serious part? Am I not serious enough?
Serious narrator.
And now it's time to set the scene. Out upon the hillside green. Reclining there in slumber deep, a group of lookers after sheep.
The reason why we've not called them shepherds, it's because nothing rhymes with them but leopards. And in Israel, they're very, very few. Except maybe in Galilee Zoo.
All at once, a flash of light fair gave those shepherds quite a fright.
I can't believe what I'm seeing. A shining grey angelic being. I hear them singing that famous song.
So come on, get it on. I don't know what you're waiting for. Your time is coming, don't be late. Hey, hey, so come on, see the light on your face. Let it shine, just let it shine. Let it shine.
Stop!
Oh, no, not that one.
Aha!
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king.
Yes, that's the one they're meant to sing.
Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful, O ye nations, rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
Okay. It's a bit too much, thanks.
Oh, sorry. Fear not.
The angels said with voice like thunder.
That hardly rent the heavens asunder.
Fear not.
The angels said in a slightly louder voice.
Who picked him for the part? A pretty poor choice.
Fear not.
He said that made us quake.
Are you sure you haven't made a mistake?
Yeah.
We're only shepherds. The very least. Would you like a rabbi?
Perhaps a priest?
A Levite, scribe or Pharisee? I'm sure you really can't mean me.
Stop being so hard on yourself. It's not good for your health. I know that you can change. So clear your head and come run. You only have to open your eyes. You might just get a big surprise. And it may feel good. And you might wanna smile, smile, smile. Oh, don't you let your demons pull you down. Cause you can have it all. You can have it all. So come on, oh come on, get it on. I don't know what you're waiting for. Your time is coming. Don't be late, hey, so come on, see the light on your face, let it shine, just let it shine, let it shine.
Are you sure you want us? Not Ed Sheeran, Elton, or some other celebrity? As I'm sure you really can't mean me.
Woo!
No. Ed, you've taken over too much at Christmas. Off you go now. Go on. I'm the singer right here. Okay, one song. But only one song, dear. Only one song.
Can my mate sing too? His name is Elton.
Oh, go on then. So long as you sing your Christmas song.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Ed Sheeran and Elton John. And they will sing to you their song, Merry Christmas.
Build a fire and gather round the tree. Fill a glass and maybe come and sing.
You've got this, Ed.
With me.
Amazing. Thanks, Ed. Anyway, back to it. Fear not. I bring good news.
They're putting down the price of booze?
For you, in David's town this night, is born a baby.
That's all right. It can't be mine, because I'm not married.
Well, you listen. This message is from heaven that I've carried. So shut your noise, stop messing round, just get yourselves down to Bethlehem town.
Shall I bring beers or wine?
No, just yourselves would be fine.
I could bring a leg of lamb.
No. Off you go to see the baby king. Now scram.
So up they got, and down they chased. To Bethlehem town they made great haste.
Come on, guys, we'll get there faster in my Lamborghini.
I prefer to go in my Volkswagen. Woof!
What the... Why would he prefer a VW?
Don't worry about him. He's a German shepherd.
Now, before we go, do we have all our sheep?
Yep. We've definitely got all 100 of them.
Are you sure we have 100?
Yep. 100. Yep, I rounded them up myself.
Do we have enough food for this journey?
I'm fine for food. I ate some shepherd's pie.
Yes.
He was pretty angry about it, actually.
Oi, you lot!
What?
You heard.
The angel flew away sheepishly after that one.
Sheepishly, you... In the end, they called a taxi, to go and see the baby king.
Simon Cowell was the name. I think it's time for a good old sing.
I suppose you will want to listen to some Ed Sheeran, right?
Nah, we got this.
Okay, guys, let me stop you there. That was awful. Have you got another song?
Get this party started on a Saturday night. Everybody's waiting for us to arrive. Sending out the message to all of my friends. We'll be looking flashy in our Mercedes Benz. We got lots of style, check out our very things.
Okay, guys, look, that's the worst audition I've ever seen. It's a no from me.
Baby in the straw.
Eek!
They cried.
Wow!
And
cool!
They gathered round to have a peep. They gave the baby a woolly sheep.
They handed Mary a leg of lamb for their Sunday roast.
Oi!
But this next moment, they cherished the most.
Jesus, I want you to know that there may be some times when I may not be around, like this. But I'll still always come back, like this. And sometimes I may be away longer, like this. But I'll still always come back, like this.
And sometimes I see you around the street and want to say hi, while staying cool and not saying anything by doing this.
He is so amazing.
Yeah, I know. Look at him.
Jesus. Jesus. Hey, Jesus. Nothing. I don't even think that's his name.
Oh, look, he's closing his eyes. Oh, look, he's opening his eyes.
He doesn't do much, does he?
No, this is pretty much it.
You guys want to get some coffee?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you guys later.
Oh, I should probably come back.
Ooh, coochie-coo.
Oh, bless.
Coochie-coo. Oh, look, he's closing his eyes again.
Then off they went back to the fire to talk about this new Messiah.
Meanwhile, in far off, far east.
Let me try. Meanwhile, mean whale. You're a mean whale.
Okay, I can take over for a bit.
Meanwhile, in far-off eastern lands, the three wise men have spotted something pivotal to their winter travel plans.
The wise men from the east were men of great minds, wisdom beyond understanding. Knowledge as deep as the ocean. They were truly scholars of the skies, and only a fair few could reach their levels of thought and reason.
Dave, keep your telescope on the stars and the planets.
Yeah, not cool, Dave. And stop spying on our neighbour Janet.
She doesn't mind. She likes me. Last week, she called me a bit of a looker.
Peeping Tom was a phrase she actually used.
Well, actually, Janet next door said I was a bit of a superhero in her eyes. Spider-Man to the rescue!
No, she called the police to say you spied on her, man.
Nah, honestly, bruv, she digs me. She said I was a bit of an animal and wants to have Chinese with me one night.
I distinctly remember, in her last complaint letter, saying, if you were an animal, you would be a Peking duck.
Okay, I'll realign my gaze. Jeez, guys.
Take a look at the bright star.
Not you again! I'll report you!
That way.
But she's going to mention me in her diary.
Back to me in the meantime, the narrators are in no fit state. In far off eastern clime, the three wise men carried on their chat in rhyme.
So we gather here today to ponder the stars. We think there may be a sign.
Yes, this alignment of stars coming together means a new king. This is Jai.
We must follow it west with gifts for the king and a chance to worship him. A very long journey we must make. Let's think of things we need to take.
I have a gift. It's brand new.
What is it? It looks like it's icky goo.
It's the finest frankincense. It costs me lots and lots of pence.
It's smelly, sticky and runny.
Oh, leave it out. It costs me loads and loads of money.
I've got myrrh.
You've got what?
Myrrh.
Myrrh?
No, man. Myrrh.
Manure?
Ugh.
Pongy.
Myrrh? Actually, it's mystic, dark and mysterious. It speaks of death and all things serious. A gift so strange to give a baby. I wonder, am I mistaken, maybe?
Maybe, Dave. Anyway, I'm gonna rub my lamp and see the genie appear.
You twit! That's the panto we did last year. You're supposed to bring a gift of gold.
Ooh. What I would have done if I'd been told. But wait, although this lamp is an old one, I'm fairly sure that it is golden.
Ah. I've also got the caramels you asked for.
Yeah.
The perfect travel suite.
Caramels?
Yes, caramels. Don't forget to order 3 caramels for the journey. Yours, Alan.
Camels, Dave. Camels. Don't worry, I can call a taxi. I know a man with a cab.
Is that Simon Camel's X Factor Taxis?
Yep, he's fab. I'll just give him a call. Right. Right. Hello?
Simon Camel's X Factor Taxis!
Hi. We need a taxi for free.
Where would you like picking up from, darling?
That would be 3 Quality Street, East Town, WI53 M3N, the East. Little joke for those reading the subtitles.
And where would you be headed to, love?
Somewhere towards the West.
Is that it? Any more specific, sweetheart?
Yeah, sorry. A bit vague. We're aiming for that star, but
Starbucks? Well, we need to go west, dear. There's one just round the corner from you.
No. Not Starbucks. We're aiming for that star, but we don't exactly know where it'll end up, because a star could end...
Costa? Well, you should have said, dear. It's one about a mile from you. And we can definitely take you there.
No. We don't want to go to Costa. We don't know where the star is going to end up, because the star could end up anywhere in the West.
Oh, so where do you want to go again, babe?
I'm not sure, but I'm thinking Jerusalem would be near, though.
Oh, Nero, Cafe Nero. There's one about...
No, we don't need a coffee.
I could do with a coffee.
I meant Jerusalem would be near, though.
Sweetheart.
Never mind. We'll go to Jerusalem.
Splendid. What name should I put that under?
Greg's the name to put down.
Oh, you want to go to Greg's?
No.
You know that you don't need to go to Jerusalem for a Greg's. I can see this one about 400 yards from
you. Okay, just put it under the name Alan.
Was this Alan like Greg's?
No. We don't need a coffee. We don't need pastries. We don't need to go to Greg's. We just want a taxi to Jerusalem for free under the name Alan.
No need to be short. You should have just said so. So, unfortunately, another gentleman has just booked the last taxi going that way.
What?
Don't worry yourself, though, Flower. He's happy to share. It's a large taxi and the owner, Simon Camel, will be driving it himself.
Oh, great. We'll take it. See you in a bit.
All right then, sweet cheeks. The taxi will be with you soon. Have a wonderful evening.
While you're waiting for the taxi, do you want to hear a joke about the three wise men? I said, while you wait, do you want to hear a joke about the three wise men? Oh, come on. Useless. Actually, maybe you're not as useless as I first thought. I can use you as a very good example of a very bad audience. Oh, shut up and listen. Here's the joke then. Are you ready? Right, here we go. Three wise men were travelling from the east, and they carried gifts to the baby in the manger. They had gold and frankincense. But wait, there's more. You guys missed a trick there.
Taxi.
Oh. We three kings of Orient are one in a taxi, one in a car, one in a scooter, blowing his hooter, following yonder star. Ooh. Oh, you lot are so boring. Okay, be boring and go in a taxi. This is one you will like. We three kings from the east travelling somewhere, trying to sell some cheap underwear. They're fantastic, no elastic. 25 quid a pair. Ooh.
Taxi.
Ah, the desert. Long time no see. Let's go.
Follow that star. I've always wanted to say that in a taxi, just like in the movies.
On a dark desert highway, cool wind in my hair, warm smell of fajitas rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I saw a shimmering light. My head grew heavy and my sight grew dim. I had to stop for the night. Welcome to the Camel's Taxi Service. Such a lovely place, such a lovely place, such a lovely place. Plenty of room at the Camel's Taxi Service. Any time of year, any time of year, you can find it here.
Okay, guys, let me stop you there. That was the worst audition I've ever heard. Have you all got a second?
Just the three of us, we can make it if we try. Just the three of us, just the three of us, just the three of us, following bright stars in the sky. Just the three of us, you and I see the crystal raindrops fall, and the beauty of it all is when the star comes shining through. To make those rainbows in my mind, when I think of you sometimes, and I want to spend some time with you.
And you, and you.
Just the three of us, we can make it if we try. Just the three of us, just the three of us, just the three of us, following bright stars in the sky. Just the three of us, you and I.
Okay, guys, gotta be honest, I really didn't like that. I absolutely loved it. But to be honest, I've got a bit lost. Which way now?
Go west, life is peaceful there. Go west, in the open air. Go west, baby, you and me. Go west, it's is our destiny.
Go west,
starring winter time.
Go west,
we will do just fine.
Go west,
where the skies are blue.
Go west,
this is what we're gonna do together.
Oopsie, yes from me.
Oh, son of a camel. So off they set upon their way. But oh, how Simon Camel's X-Factor taxis sway. Is your line?
They travelled incredibly slow.
Yeah. That was slower than a herd of snails going uphill, you know.
By the way, what carol is heard in the desert?
I don't know. What carols do you hear in the desert?
Oh, camel, ye faithful.
That joke was bad. This journey is slow. Please don't go. We'll see you later in the Anything Goes Nativity Show.
He does have good hair, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Should I go along?
Get ready to boo, prepare to hiss, as we meet the villain of this piece.
Glad you got that rhyme right.
'Tis Herod the Great, he's ever so sneaky. He loves to hate, and his voice is rather squeaky.
Just practicing Bach's Toccata and Fugue in D minor.
Greetings, my peasant friends. I am Herod the Great Dane.
Did he say Great Dane?
As in the dog.
Who said that?
Him.
Well, I guess I blame somebody up there.
I heard just recently of a baby born nearby and thought that maybe... For my royal throne, there's a contender. But watch out, I can be quite the pretender. I am the only star around here. Let me sing to you, my dears. Hit it, Salma! Idiot! A little too much chlorine in his gene pool.
I got this.
My little buttercup has the sweetest smile.
Did you even read the script, boy? You couldn't pour water out of a boot with instructions on the heel. Come on, cue in the song for me, now. Because I'm bad, I'm bad,
shabam. The road, because it was the chicken's day off.
Ba-dum-tsh.
Why did Donald Trump continuously decorate his Christmas tree? Because people kept shouting, moron! Moron! Oi, audience! If you got a problem with me, write the problem on a piece of paper, fold it in half again, then shove it up your...
Oh, I thought he said ass.
As the town of Bethlehem dreams, King Herod plots, King Herod schemes, King Herod plans what he will do. Now all together, let's give him a boo!
Oh, please don't scream and please don't yell. It really upsets me. Does it help? Call out if you must. Look out behind you. I promise you this much, I won't mind you. I'm a cunning fox. I'm a slippery snake. When I find the kid, his life I'll take.
Oops, sorry.
Hey there! I had more to say. A whole monologue about my childhood. No? I'll be back.
The wise men eventually did arrive, Simon camels dropping them on the palace drive.
That taxi only had first gear. We've been travelling for well over a year.
We slept in the daytime and we travelled at night so we could keep that star in sight.
Speaking of the star, where is it now?
It's behind you!
Oh, no, it's not.
Oh, I should have been Mary.
Oh, yes, it is!
Oh, yes, it is. The star is down there. Oh.
Hey, are you all right back there, Lizzie?
Yeah, fine.
Come on, boys.
Fearing no evil, suspecting no malice, the wise men went along to ask at the palace.
Oh, hi, chaps. Sorry, just doing a bit of maintenance. The presentation will start very soon.
Tell me if you're really there. Don't make
Your Majesty, I present Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, the three wise men from the East.
We prefer Greg, Alan, and Dave.
Ow.
Your Majesty, I present Reg, Ali, and Dale, the three wise men from
it's
the...
Greg, Alan, and... never mind.
Okay, enough now. Greetings, Eastern visitors. So I hear you are searching for a child. Who did that disgusting bodily sound?
Not me, Your Majesty.
Well, it could have been me. I never know these days.
You did have all that bean and onion casserole last night.
There's a recipe for tear gas right there.
Okay, enough of this nonsense. These jokes stink. Although I could use that recipe for tear gas at some point. Now, what do you want, Gina, Alice and Pam?
It's Greg, Alan and Dave.
That's what I said.
Never mind. Where will this baby king be born?
We've followed his star from dusk till dawn.
For many a mile.
For months on end.
We pray. For which way now shall our footsteps bend?
Herod seethed and Herod raged. He was like a lion caged. He wanted to shout and scream and swear. Instead, he whispered.
Have a care. Go find the child. And when you do, tell me so I can coochie-coo. So I can rock and sway the child. Treat him gently. Treat him mild. And when you wise men are not looking, that's the plan that I've been cooking. I'll kill the kid, I'll choke the brat. Let's see you worship after that. So off you go. Off you go. Off you. Off you go. Off you go. Off you go. Oh.
Line!
Here's your line.
I said lines. Stupid boy, I meant the text. Not a text, the script. Boy, bring me the script. I've had enough of this incompetence. Stop this now.
To be fair, it's you who don't know their lines.
Can somebody just give me the words? If that's a dictionary, turn your sorry little self around. Toodle-pip. Can somebody please just tell me what I say next? Oh, you should have just said. Alan, show the man.
Okay. Hurry up. Come on.
So, off you go, along your way. See you later. Have a nice day. Have a nice day! I'd never say that.
Odd guy, he didn't actually answer the question about where to find the Child King.
Yeah, and he kept talking to you. And he loved that red light thing too.
Head to Bethlehem, but expect loads of traffic congestion.
Hey, Messiah, King will be born there. Hmm. It says in my scroll, take our camels as it's rather a long stroll.
Let's go to Bethlehem.
Psst! You wouldn't get someone back there to scratch my nose, would you? No. Would be nice if you could. No? Okay.
This guy's got a body back here.
He's behind you.
Stop it!
He's always got somebody behind him.
Cheek.
Cheeks are certainly the word.
Full moon out tonight, lads. Come on.
Didn't God say three camels?
Oh no, only one camel. This will do.
How does one mount a camel?
Just come on.
Just keep in mind that the word hump in the script is a noun, not a verb.
I wasn't humping you.
I perch like a lady.
I mean man.
I told you it was a woman. Thanks. The wise men looked again for the star to guide them.
Where is the star so bright?
Oh, there it
crumbs
is.
Wrong side.
Knots. Crumbs. Oh.
Oh no,
he's
not.
Oh, no, he's not again.
Oh. He better freaking be there.
Whoa.
Oh, it's too long. Let's go, come on.
We could use that.
You lost a bit of weight.
Atkins diet.
The wise men looked again for the star to guide them.
Who hired this woman? It's a star. The freaking star part.
Let me see. The star is on fire. It's no good at all.
No, the star is ruined. I can't wear this.
Well, how about use this instead?
What? Are you joking? I'm not putting that on. That's ridiculous.
You'll have to do. It's the best we've got.
I'm a professional actor. I'm not here for this.
Oh, for goodness sake, put whatever he has for you on. Let's move this along.
I told you, you can't wear that.
I didn't sign up for this. This is ridiculous.
The wise men looked again for the star to guide them.
Where is the star so bright?
Go, get up there.
And glittery.
We must follow that shiny rainbow?
Star? It looks like it's hovering over Bethlehem. Let's go.
About time.
Oi, you've got such a hump, camel. Jeez, let us actors do the main job.
Excuse me, I think you will find that I'm carrying you guys in the show.
Whilst on their journey, the wise men will now sing all five verses of We Three Kings.
They are not.
Whoa!
Oh, boy.
Gosh, she's definitely got the hump.
They found the baby soon enough and opened their gifts of gold, and stuff, although Jesus was older as they took so long. And the stable was revamped and the manger and hay were gone.
A bit of fake snow wouldn't go amiss for such a special moment like this. Is that it? That all you got?
Most of the budget went on the gold lamp. They insisted it must be real gold.
Don't worry, they can put special effects on after.
It's live panto, duh.
Sure it is. Hey, wise men, what are you waiting for?
Well, I rubbed my gold lamp, but nothing occurred.
That's last year's panto, you numpty. Raven, you heard.
Well, here is some gold for the baby man. Whoa.
Oh, wow.
Stubbly.
You bought me gold? No, you shouldn't have. It's too much. But, I mean, it's not a symbolic thing, right? We get to keep this.
Yep, the gold is yours.
I'll be looking after that until the boy is 18.
Wow, just wow. What a gift. Life-changing. Can we give you a hug?
Sure.
Joseph, give the man a hug.
Oh.
Mary, I too have a gift for you.
Oh, you've bought a gift too.
Go on, unwrap it.
Joseph, it's frankincense. Oh, I love it.
Oh.
It'll be so good for our new home. We can make candles.
Mm.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh.
Joseph, I'm always saying how much I love frankincense.
Oh. Yes, Mary, yes. Yeah, you do. No, you do. Oh, yes, you do say that. Yes.
Thank you, wise man. Alan, is it? This is so nice. We must give you a hug.
Okay.
Joseph, the man wants a hug.
Give him a sniff.
Oh, smells great.
Oh, okay. Give me a hug. Come here. Give me a hug.
Warm and cozy, isn't it?
I've come bearing a third gift.
What? No way. This is incredible. Another gift?
Go on, take a look.
It looks like a big, fat, full gift. Joseph, look at this. It's... I love this. Remind me, What do you call this?
It's myrrh.
Yes. Yes, I've heard about myrrh. Yes, I've read a lot about myrrh. Remind me, what is myrrh?
It's an analgesic.
Anal? What?
An analgesic. We've needed an analgesic, haven't we, Joseph?
I don't know what that is.
For pain relief?
Could have done with that earlier. I mean, great.
You can cook with it, like, if you want.
Great. I love good myrrh recipes.
You do?
Potatoes with myrrh it is.
It was going to be a stocking filler, but then I saw these guys got all the gold and the frankincense, and I didn't want to get too much gold, so I...
gave her myrrh.
No, that's wise. You can't have, too much gold. Yeah. I'm so happy I got myrrh.
Can I also have a hug?
All right, of course. A hug for you as well.
That's my toy! Mum! Oh, hi, Mum! Look, a monster!
Whoa!
I best be off.
Help anyone? Oh, no.
Could the audience please stay in their seats? The show will commence soon.
A little light, please.
She's in, mate.
Conscious one next to him.
Wise men settled down for the night. by the golden glow of the firelight.
The star Rainbow, still visible above Bethlehem, still shining rather quite bright.
Listen to this. People can be so mean. That present was so bad. Who even gives myrrh? You should be ashamed of yourself. That's the worst present since my late husband was bought an ejector seat for his helicopter. Hashtag loser.
Dave, you gotta stop reading Twitter, mate. All that abuse.
Oh no, that was just a text from my mum.
What?
I mean, that ejector seat wasn't that bad. My dad loved it. My mum said he was in bits after trying it out for the first time.
Anyway, lights out. It's been a long night.
That night, as the wise men dreamed, all was not as it had seemed. The angel appeared.
Or was it a genie? Oh.
That Herod is a massive meanie. Go home another way. Make it quick.
I heard that Herod was a bit of a...
So off to the east they trotted, not back to the palace where Herod had plotted.
The angel also told Joseph to take the family to Egypt to escape.
And to check out the lovely pyramid landscape.
What's that? Is Herod getting wild? The wise men of Scamford and the child.
Furious! Dare those wise men not return! How did they know I was a baddie? How did they learn? I will hunt them down with all my might! Audience, will you let me know when they're in sight? Oh no, they're not!
Oh yes, they are!
Oh no, they're not!
Oh yes, they are!
I'm done listening to you twerps! Someone else look behind me!
Well, I literally can only look forward.
Off with her head!
Is he for real? Can't you just see I'm just ahead?
Guards! Get them! What do I pay you for?
You don't.
What? We don't get paid? Well, in that case...
Are you talking to us? You want us to chop our own heads off?
Mm-hmm. Not sure that was in our training.
And we've done our level 5 decapitation.
Give me a sword and I'll do it.
I can't, Your Majesty. You aren't trained.
Not trained?
You've got to have the certificate.
And be signed off by Karen in HR.
We're beheading off then.
I'm not sure you got the joke, but I thought you executed that pun wrong.
Ah! I'll hunt them down myself! In fact, I'll hunt down every child until I find that little whippersnapper! Ah!
But Herod would not let them go. He searched high and he searched low.
Shh, you ain't seen nothing.
You'll let me know if you see those silly little people, won't you?
All together now.
They're behind you.
Mary, you are beautiful. I'll get you!
Thank you. A potato.
I believe
just
it.
A potato. Nothing to see here. Just a potato.
You literally had a tiger outfit, a sumo wrestler outfit, and you just switch hats.
I mean, I'm a potato.
Run!
Where's my boy Jesus?
Thank you, Dave. You're our hero.
Safe in God's hands, they fled with the child. Joseph strong and Mary mild. For news they waited of Herod's decease, for when they could return home in peace.
They took the child to their home again. He grew in favour with God and men. The Lord was with him as he grew. And pretty soon the Saviour knew the time was right for him to speak,
to set his face towards Holy Week. Many have travelled to see this baby king, but now it's time to end the show and let everybody sing.
cozy fire. Watch the embers glow. He did his own stunts. Natural in that donkey scene. Rubbish. Rubbish. That should have been me. Rubbish. Diva. Be honest, you're only reading these lines to see your own name. Vain. He's good looking. Cow? I was an ox. Now that's ridiculous. A sheep playing the violin, and she was miming a cello. Ridiculous. Loved that baby, didn't she? Never learned his lines. Who needs the real Ed Sheeran when you've got Kieran? Better looking than the real Simon Cowell. Didn't take too much effort for him to look confused. Third choice for the part. Did he even say any of his lines? A solid organist in real life too. He deserved that cake. Finally a good actor. Said he went to RADA. Cleaning the loos, I reckon. For the joy of it. His bit was actually pretty fun, to be fair. Only there because her mum sent a strongly worded letter. Less stage school, more acting a fool. Rory's accent, phenomenal. Even a bit whiny. What a smile, worthy of a Hollywood overdub. Oh, think you know someone famous, do you? Know someone from the Panto? Gonna tell all your little friends at the Christmas party? Gemma Arterton? Who's heard of that? Now these guys, they literally have their own faces, but the director said, no, I can do better. Let's stick their hand up a felt puppet and show that instead. And the singers, auto-tune, muted. These lot are clearly the ugly ones. Best not seen. Keep them behind the scenes.
7654321.
On the first day of Christmas.
Now that is a cool job. What a privilege to light my face.
Day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me.
Has his own entourage. What an actor.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love said to me five golden rings. Calling bird, three French hens, two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Who was a partridge? Who was a pear tree? Well, I don't know, so please don't ask me. But I can bet those are terrible gifts to give.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me six geese a laying,
five golden
bad, three French hens, two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Seventh day of Christmas, my true love said to me seven swans are swilling, six geese are laying,
five golden rings,
four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love said to me eight maids are milking,
laying,
five golden rings,
four calling birds, three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me nine ladies dancing,
eight maids are milking,
seven swans are swimming, six geese are laying,
five golden rings. Woo!
Four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Who was a partridge? Who was a pear tree? Well, I don't know, so please don't ask me. But I can bet there's a terrible gift to give.
On the tenth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me ten lords are leaping,
nine ladies dancing,
eight maids are milking,
seven swans are swimming, six geese are laying,
five golden rings.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
The 11th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 11 pipers piping,
10 lords are leaping,
9 ladies dancing,
8 maids are milking,
7 swans are swimming, 6 geese are laying,
5 golden rings,
4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 12 farmers drumming, 11 pipers piping,
10 lords are leaping,
9 ladies dancing,
8 maids are milking,
7 swans are swimming, 6 geese are laying,
5. Hello, hi, cleaner, excuse me, hello, I need help, I'm kind of stuck up here. No, no.